to this video, testing the Fenix 5 Plus X. You also have it like in the S and the normal one. This is the biggest one, so the 51 millimeter. I don't have a big wrist, and I asked a lot of friends and they don't thought this was too big for my wrist. Actually, I do think it's a little too big, but it's just perfect while sporting. Show it more in depth, but it has navigation, it measures everything, like of course pace with the GPS, all the times, heart rate of course, but also VO2 and lots of other stuff. I search a place here where there's not a lot of wind noise, also not a lot of road noise, but perhaps you hear some birds. Sorry for that. But why would you be navigating with the bike, running, climbing or hiking? I think it's always good to have a device which is not your phone, which can navigate, because the phone can go like battery dead. And if you don't have an Accupack, you have like a very beautiful watch which will navigate you to the closest restaurant, the closest cabin, like if you are in the mountains, or just like navigating on the roads to the newest pub or something. So how is the visibility? I'm riding through sunlight and shade now. It is on 100%, the screen light, so the battery will go dead the most quickly at this point. I want to show you for the video. Normally I use it at like 20 or 30% and I just look at it when it's shade. And you can see that we need to go to the right, so let's do that. Keep on left, right on cycleway. This is a difficult place. So here on the right. So right on cycleway. On purpose, I took a wrong route, and then I wanted to show you how it reacts. It says possible, make a U-turn, and that gives me the one flaw of the navigating on Garmin devices, but also on Mio devices and other devices which are not based on Google Maps. I think Google Maps is the best navigation device has the best map usability there is. And all other companies like TomTom, like Garmin, like other map-based companies will provide you a map, but they are not as good as Google. I don't think this Phoenix will be the best option for you if you have like a telephone with Google Maps, with an EcuPack. Perhaps it's better, but I think this is more in handy. You see it on your watch, just on your screen, or the Garmin eTrex. That's also a navigation device from Garmin. So
there we go.
There we are. This is quite high for me. So, on the top now. I had to brake very fast, so the heart rate rose a little. But now it goes down to no zone. The warm-up zone has been left. And I hope it will go down quickly. That will show a good shape. The more fit you are, the more in balance, like very healthy, the quicker the heart rate goes up and down. And if you are, for example, besides that, very tired, then the heart rate will become, it will move slower. I had a very busy day at the office, so kind of tired, but the overall shape is very well at this moment. I did a bicycle race of 360 kilometers in one day. A couple of weeks ago, I went to the Dolomites and I ran like five times a week, four times a week. So I think it's quite good. And happy to see this. So, yeah, it's nice. It's a lot better than the Garmin 110 I tested. Sorry for the grill, for the glasses. Still, there are some people who are doubting about this kind of heart rate monitoring. I do think a chest belt from Polar, like the M600, is perhaps a little bit more accurate, more precise, and especially more quick. But nowadays, the optical heart rate sensors, I think they are very good enough for me. If it's good enough for you, it's totally up to you. For me, it's the difference between the one training and the other way more important than the last measurement of the heart rate, the last beat. Because what does it say if it's like one beat higher or lower? It's just first thing is, of course, how do you feel about your heart rate? How do you feel in general? And then you can train on heart rate, but not the opposite. So some people only train on heart rate, but I do think you have to like keep attention to the mood. I had a very busy day today, so that's why I don't go to 170 or 175 to don't exhaust myself too much. So that's only my opinion. Hope you liked it and rate it with a little. I think a couple of things, the disadvantages I found. Two for me. It's too expensive for me. This one is like 650. It's the Sapphire Phoenix 5 Plus X model. And the navigation is perfect, but there is a big but. And also, already told you, it's not as good as like Google Maps, in my opinion. It shows all the little routes. I didn't have any problems with it, but I read a couple of opinions of other people that told me that sometimes, like if you are very remote in the mountains, it doesn't show all the nice small paths that Google does show. But for the rest, I think it looks very nice. You can, of course, swap all the bands. I think it's a watch for like, not for your life, but you will buy it for years and years and it won't go out of date. It looks sturdy, it looks rough, it looks cool. I think it also looks okay when you're going to the office and you can measure anything. The problem with that, no, it's not a problem. You want to check everything. You want to do the exercises for like resting, like meditating with it. You can do all kinds of cool stuff, which I've shown you in the video. Thanks for watching. Hope you liked it and rated it with a little thumb.